show.
From Closter to Young. Looked like he was going out of bounds, however, there must have been a loose football because your Highlanders come up with that. And just like that, in a heartbeat, in the snap of a finger, it's Highlander football. First and 10, quick start for the Highlanders. Jaden Turner in the shotgun and takes a few steps back. We'll see what the call is from head referee Chuck Calvert. He's going to talk it over with one of his referees. And awaiting the call, and it's going to be on the Rough Riders. Turner in the shotgun, dropping back to pass. The pass is intercepted.
Can I get a sound check?
Turner was going deep, looking for Demetrius Simon. Didn't find him. We were unable to see who came up with the football. But it's going to be first and 10 Roosevelt from the 20. So just like that, these teams trading possessions. Closer going out to one of his wide receivers. Closer in the shotgun. It's going to be a handoff. And the running back runs into a sea of red. Your Highlanders in the red tonight. Looks to be number 22. Demarier Banks. So the Rough Riders moving the chains. Closer in the shotgun. Quick dart pass. To number one, still manages to get up and make his way to the sideline. That's Davion Fields. So it's a block in the back against the Rough Riders. It's going to push him back a few yards. that will negate the complete pass from Jackson Closter to Davion Fields. Great crowd on hand tonight for the Battle of Cedar. Your Highlanders and the Rough Riders.
We would like,
Highlander sideline is filling in the gaps. It's great to see our people, our community, our Highlander Nation turn out to the game. This is a rivalry game, the Battle of Cedar, a game that's been around for about 65 years as the pass is complete to Fields. Going back into the statistics, since the year 2004, there have been 19 games played between both of these teams. That record is 6 wins for your Highlanders, 13 wins for the Rough Riders, as the handoff to Demarie Banks will take him over the first down marker. So 6 wins for your Highlanders, 13 wins for the Rough Riders. The Highlanders coming off a 1-year winning streak, looking to make it 2. However, nothing is a given here in the North Yosemite League, especially going up against the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Closter chased out of the pocket, looking for a receiver, incomplete. So your Highlanders come into this game after falling to the Matilde Torres Toros by a score of 39-14. That was last Thursday here at McLane Stadium. A tale of 2 halves for your Highlanders, as the game was 18-14 at the half. But in the second half, the Toros pretty much ran away. Taking us to the final score. So a big third down coming up for the Highlanders, and they call third down the money down. This is the down where you've got to execute. The Rough Riders are driving down the field. It is a handoff. Swallowed quickly into a sea of red is the running back for that one, which was number 22, Demarie Banks. Defense able to get the stop on that one. They're sending back Desir Newhouse. And back deep to punt for the Rough Riders. We'll try to get a number as soon as we have one. So Mr. Excitement, Desir Newhouse, will go ahead and receive the punt. They're not going to let him get near it. It's going to bounce into the end zone for a touchback. So we're going to step away for a few seconds. This is the Battle of Cedar. You're watching it here on McLane Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of the Art Venture Academy. Welcome back to McLane Stadium, and that first play for the Highlanders is a short gain from JT Turner to Desir Newhouse. So 2nd and 4 for the Highlanders, trying to come off that first possession interception. It's JT Turner in the shotgun. He is going to take it on the run. That's going to be number 28 on the carry. It's going to be 28 with the tackle, pardon me, Bobby Wilson. Down for the Highlanders. They've got a man in motion, and there's going to be a penalty marker. We'll await what the call is. It's going to be a illegal procedure against the Highlander offense. So on third down, that's going to make things a little different for the Highlanders. More yards to work with to reach the first down marker, which currently resides at the 30. It'll be Turner in the shotgun. He's going to drop back to pass. He's going to evade the pressure. He's going to air it out to Newhouse. And Newhouse unable to come up with it. He's going to get the flag. To wait as we see the Highlanders right now in the stands lighting up the night. Going to be pass interference on Roosevelt and a hold against the Highlanders, which are going to offset. So offsetting penalties right here.
All right, Rough Rider fans, it's going to be a repeat section and want to get some of the
third down.
Make sure to bring your five-star app to the stairs at the bottom toward the cheerleaders. I will be there. Please show your five-star app all students to get your freebies.
As we see the Highlander faithful lighting up the night, we're going to see if the Highlander offense can light up the Rough Rider defense. Turner dropping back. It's a short scoop pass. Still on the ground is TJ McMillan the third. And the Highlanders move the chains on third down. Turner to McMillan the third. Currently on the 41. So here come the Highlanders traveling the field. Turner in the shotgun. It's a handoff to McMillan the third. Multiple Roosevelt tackles. Off to McMillan the third, picked up about three. Turner in the shotgun once again, flanked by McMillan. We'll see what Turner has up his sleeve. There's a man in motion, which is Juju Scott. That's going to be a Rough Riders interception. Number 20, Sergio Hakwinde, coming up with the football. Ball right at midfield, and we will see what they have in store. Closter in the shotgun. flanked by his running back, which is Banks. Quick strike pass to Davion Fields. Demetrius Simon on the tackle. So the Rough Riders gain half the yards. It's another handoff this time to the running back. And he's going to get quickly wrapped down. And it is Zeke Mendibles for what it looks like. Number zero.
Quickly met by Zeke Mendibles. Highlander Nation, make some noise. That's going to bring up third down.
So another third down for the Highlanders. Good chance to make a statement, and Closter's gonna get hit. It's gonna be a scoop and score. What are they calling? It's gonna be a loose ball. It's gonna be called, well, too often you try not to question the calls from a referee, but Closter is gonna be met, and that's gonna bring up fourth down. And now a penalty marker flies. We'll see what the call is going to be. It will probably be an unsporting conduct on the Highlanders. And Closter, ladies and gentlemen, had been completely met by one of the Highlander tacklers that we were unable to see. But the Highlanders probably weren't too pleased with the end result of that play. And the result is the Rough Riders are still alive. The ball's going to be spotted at the 39. At the 30, pardon. Certainly not what the Highlanders wanted to have. Closer. It's going to be chased out of the pocket. He is looking deep. He is looking deep. Looking for four. Incomplete. So Jackson Closter, the senior quarterback, standing at 6'3", 205, looking for Jeremy Young. There were about three Highlanders in the zone of that one. And here we go. Closter on the drop back. Looking for Fields, incomplete. Another third down coming up as you hear Thunderstruck on the bagpipes. That's the sign, it's third down, Highlander Nation. And Closter will drop back. The pass is complete. Trying to see who the wide receiver was.
The pass is complete to Davion Fields. Dazier Newhouse on the tackle. Roosevelt, first down.
So it's a first down for Roosevelt. The ball is now on the 17 inside of the red zone. Closter is going to complete to Fields once again. Multiple Highlanders on the stop. Among them, number 9, Jonathan Vargas. Second and 5 for Roosevelt. It's going to be a handoff, which is not going to go anywhere. That was 22. Demarie Banks.
Demarie Banks, the ball carrier.
Third down once more. However, this time it is inside of the red zone. Closter kind of took a second or two. He's going to air it out, and he's going to be met. He is going to be met. That is number 50, Juan Manuel Raygosa Jr. And that's the sensational freshman, 5'11", 190 pounds, Juan Manuel Raygosa Jr., taking down Jackson Closter. It's going to be an intentional grounding call on the Rough Riders, which will drive them slightly back.
Intentional grounding called on the Rough Riders.
So the Roosevelt offense is staying out there. Closter is in the shotgun with Banks to his left. And here we go. Closter drops back, feeling the pressure. No, he's going to roll out. And it is incomplete. Highlanders take over on downs.
The pass is incomplete. Turnover on downs. Line on the play.
It's going to be a hold against the Rough Riders. It is declined. Highlander football.
It's a hold on the Rough Riders, which is declined. Let me try that again. Turnover on downs. McLane, Highlanders football.
So the Highlanders will take over on downs. We're going to step away. You are watching McLane Highlander football and Highlander highlights, the production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Production Academy. Welcome back to McLane Stadium. Dying seconds of the first quarter. Deadlocked at zero, your Highlanders and the Rough Riders. As it's a handoff that won't get much. Just might be the last play of the first quarter. Highlanders aren't too excited coming to the line, not rushing, I should say, coming to the line. And that will take us to the end of the first. It's 0-0. You're watching McLane Highlander football and Highlander highlights. Production of the students of the Art Venture Academy. We'll be right back. Welcome back after the quarter break. Second quarter, teams have switched sides. And here we go, trying to clear room for the quarterback keeper for Noah Zamora. Chains are the Highlanders that run by Zamora. This time we see him in at quarterback for JT Turner. So he comes back to the Highlander huddle. The Roosevelt Rough Riders, meanwhile, come into this game after a 65-30 loss against the Sunnyside Wildcats here at McLane Stadium. That was on Friday night. So they come into this game with the record of 2-3, while your Highlanders come into this game with the record of 3-2. It's going to be a handoff to McMillan III, and there ain't no fooling the Roosevelt Rough Riders on that one. Quickly met by Malik Tatum. Simply no pulling the wool over the eyes of the Rough Riders. They read that one in a jiffy, and TJ McMillan III goes down. So it's going to be two wide receivers to Zamora's left and two to his right. Zamora dropping back to pass. Going deep, intended for Newhouse, but incomplete. So Desir was one of the scorers for the Highlanders in the last game against Torres on the receiving touchdown. The other one was Demetrius Simon. Those accounted to be the only two touchdowns for the Highlanders last week. Again, as we just mentioned previously, falling to the Torres Toros 39-14. However, that was on Thursday night. This is Friday night. It's a whole new ball game. It's a whole new day. It's a new day. Yes, it is. Or a new night, I should say, here at McLane Stadium. Zamora will drop back. He's going to air it out. And it's going to be a completed pass to Demetrius Simon. Just like that, moving the chains are the Highlanders. Zamora airing it out. And Demetrius Simon, the 6'1", 145 sophomore, talented on the gridiron as he is on the hardwood, as are multiple players on this Highlander squad, able to move the chains for the Highlanders. Zamora in the shotgun, dropping back, airing it out to Zeke Mendibles. Mendibles is gonna go on the run. He's going to get brought down by Demarie Banks.
Pass is complete to Zeke Mendibles. Another McLane Highlander first down.
And just like that, your Highlanders are into Roosevelt territory. The ball is on the 40. In the words of legendary coach Hank Stram, Highlanders are matriculating the ball down the field. We'll see, however, how they do. Zamora in the shotgun. McMillan to his left. Feeling the pressure. Feeling the pressure. He's going to evade it. Rolling out of the pocket. That's going to be enough for the first, it appears. Zamora on the run. Penalty markers will await the decision from the head referee. So Zamora able to evade the pressure. Let's see what the call is. The referee looking in the direction of the Rough Riders. Now in the direction of the Highlanders. It's a personal foul face mask on the Rough Riders, which will move it forward for the Highlanders. the Highlanders into the red zone. And let me tell you something, folks. The trips to the red zone, you've got to make them count. Here we go. Zamora in the shotgun. McMillan the third is the feature back. Not a lot of room to run. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide for T.J. McMillan
really
III.
Because they're going to chant back at us.
5'10", 180, the senior. T.J. McMillan
III. Where is the party?
An exciting player to watch.
Then we wait for McLane to
so second
back.
And 10
nice
from
and
the 15.
Ready? One,
here
two,
we go.
Three.
We have
A-R-T-Y, party, party,
three
side.
Wide receivers.
The
to the quarterback's right, Zamora dropping back, rolling out, the pass is caught. That's Noah Zamora completing to Juju Scott. Just like that, the Highlanders are on the board. So Valadez, the senior kicker, is on to try the point-after touchdown. Out of the hold of Noah Zamora, Valadez will put it up, and it is no good. On the Rough Riders.
It will be encroachment on the Rough Rider defense. And it looks like your Highlanders will re-kick.
So Valadez going to get another shot at redemption. Last Thursday, he was able to go 2 for 2 on those extra points. The extra point is going to be good. Go ahead and stop the presses, folks. Going to go ahead and move the ball forward. We will be right back. Thank you. welcome back to McLane Stadium. It is the Highlanders currently in the lead, 7-0 against the Roosevelt Rough Riders. The Highlanders defense will now take the field. Closter's pass is complete to Jeremy Young.
T-Y, party's on our side. Where is the party? The party's over here.
Highlanders take over. It was a fumble. We do apologize for losing quick track of the play. However, here we are. The ball is right on the 39.
Ball on the 39 for your Highlander offense.
So we will see how the Highlander offense gets it going. Man in motion, which is Newhouse. The handoff is to McMillan the third, and there he goes, bouncing to the left. Still on his feet, still churning the legs.
T.J. McMillan III on the run. Another Highlanders first down. Flag on the plate.
The call is going to be sideline warning on the Roosevelt Rough Riders. The chains are still moving for the Highlanders. So there we go. It's going to be a pass complete. So the Highlander offense currently finds themselves with actually a second and goal. Correction, make that a second and goal from the 8.
Second and goal, Highlanders.
That's TJ McMillan for the score.
Touchdown, Highlanders! TJ McMillan the third from 8 yards out.
TJ McMillan the third taking it in for the touchdown. So we've got Scott on the score sheet with the touchdown, and now add the name of TJ McMillan the third. So here we go, Valadez. The kick is up, and this time it is good. So ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break, step away. You are watching McLane Highlander Football and Highlander Highlights, a production of the McLane Art Venture Academy. Welcome back, as Valadez will boot this one into the end zone for a touchback. No chance for Fields. Lots of noise tonight going on at the Battle of Cedar. You gotta give credit to both the Highlanders and the Rough Riders, both student sections. Looking pretty good right now. This game, a rivalry, has been going on since the Highlanders were founded in 1959, going on about 65 years. And the pass was complete to Jeremy Young. Both teams taking their time to come to the line. The head referee is making his way over to the Roosevelt sideline. Looks like he might be having a word with head coach Joshua Kloster. And indeed he is. And now he heads back to where the action is. Second and 13. The ball is on the 17.
Ball on the 17.
Kloster dropping back to pass. Looking in this general direction. Intended for four. Young, Demetrius Simon on the coverage. Here's the money down for the Highlander defense. Currently up by 14. It's Kloster dropping back, airing it out. And the pass is overthrown of the receiver.
Ball's incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
So fourth down. Here's Desir Newhouse back deep to receive. The punter for the Rough Riders is Julian Maldonado.
Julian Maldonado back to punt. Desir Newhouse.
So Newhouse now stepping to about the 45. Maldonado. It's a line drive straight to Newhouse. And there he goes. Start the engines. Desir Newhouse. And he is met by about one or two Highlander tacklers, partly Roosevelt tacklers. Penalty markers on the play.
Flag on the play.
We'll see what the call is. So Desir Newhouse was able to take the line drive. However, we'll see if the return stands or if it's going to move back. It's going to be a hold on the Highlanders. And that will negate the new house run back. So instead of starting in Rough Rider territory, the Highlanders will begin in their own. Noah Zamora still in there at quarterback. We had seen Jaden Turner in the opening series, however this time, the Highlanders sticking with Zamora. Dropping back out of the pocket, completing the Newhouse. And there goes Newhouse. Start those engines, Azir Newhouse.
Complete from Zamora to Newhouse. Good enough for a Highlander first down.
So Newhouse able to move that ball. This time it is in Roosevelt territory. The ball currently rests on the 46. So the Rough Riders will call a timeout, and we're going to step away. You are watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. We are back. The pass is complete from Zamora to Simon. Another penalty marker on the play. Brought down by Sergio Jacuinde. Penalty marker is against the Highlanders. And that's going to negate the completion to Demetrius Simon. So now the Highlanders will start. Here come the Highlanders from the 44. Zamora in the shotgun. Mendibles, the feature back. Incomplete, looking for Newhouse. Been a good one so far here in the Battle of Cedar. Once again, reminding you, your Highlanders are on a one-game win streak in the Battle of Cedar, winning last year's face-off. And looking to make it two, however, still a whole half of football left. Zamora dropping back, going deep, Incomplete. So third down for the Highlander offense, 2:52 left in the half. Mendibles has been the feature back in the past two plays. We'll see if he stays out there or if TJ McMillan III is coming back. So Mendibles the feature back. One running back to Zamora's left and two. And Zamora slips and falls. He's gonna try to make something out of what looked to be a broken play, and he's just going to run it out of bounds. So that's going to be fourth down for the Highlanders. The ball currently at the 46. Roosevelt is sending a man deep. We've seen the Highlanders with this formation before, and yes, they will take a step back. It's gonna be Jaden Turner. Roosevelt sending their man back deep again, which is number four. And it's a sky punt that's going to take a Roosevelt bounce. So not a lot going for Jaden Turner on that punt. The Rough Riders had sent Jeremy Young back deep, however, he did not have a chance to return that one. Here come the Rough Riders from the 45. Closter rolling out to his left, and he's just going to wisely step out of bounds, feeling the pressure of about three or four Highlanders there. Second down for Closter, who is going to put it up and nowhere to go. The pass falls incomplete. Looks like there's going to be penalty marker on the field. Let's see what it is. Penalty will be on the Rough Riders. That one's going to be called on the Rough Riders. Could have appeared to be illegal participation, but we'll try to confirm what it was in a couple of seconds. So it's going to be a repeat of second down, and we've got a timeout called by. We're gonna see who called that timeout. Timeout called by the Rough Riders. We're gonna step away. You're watching Highlander Football and Highlander Highlights, the production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. Thank you. Welcome back to McLane Stadium, where you just missed a near interception by Zeke Mendivas. Boy, oh boy. Just about had it, but it falls through. And it's going to be fourth down. The Rough Riders electing to send out the offense. Pass is complete to Young. And there goes Young. All the way for the touchdown. And on fourth down, the Rough Riders make it count. I'm telling you, I don't know where that one came from, but the Rough Riders make it count when they need it to. And just like that, they are an extra point away from cutting the score in half. So the Rough Riders electing to go for two. There is Closter looking for the receiver. The pass is incomplete. So there you have it. Roosevelt has life and they are on the board. However, your Highlanders still leading by eight. We'll step away briefly. You're watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. Welcome back, Highlander football and Highlander highlights, as we await the kickoff from Julian Maldonado. And it is going to be fielded by your Highlanders. Desir Newhouse on the return.
Students, we need the beach balls down here, please, for the next activity. Leadership, bring the beach balls down. We need both of them.
So it's 14-6. Just a quick recap. Your Highlanders went up, but now we got a penalty marker on the field. And that one's gonna go against the Highlanders for unsportsmanlike conduct. So again, a quick recap. It was a touchdown pass from Noah Zamora to Juju Scott that put your Highlanders up 7-0. Then it's TJ McMillan III with a 8-yard run to make it 14-zip. And then the Roosevelt Rough Riders going for it on fourth down, completing a pass from Jackson Closter to Jeremy Young. That takes us where we are, 14-6. So Zamora operating the less than 2 minute offense. So second down for the Highlanders, second and 20 to be more exact, thanks to that penalty. 107 and counting in the half, the Highlanders don't seem to be in much of a hurry. They'd be happy taking in this 8-point lead into the locker room. So two wide receivers lining up to Zamora's right, one to his left, and one feature back. The back is, appears to be McMillan III, who is still going. Nice run, trying to churn the legs. So 32 seconds left in the half. We're going to come right back, folks. Stay right here on Highlander Highlights. You're watching McLane Highlander Football, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. Welcome back to McLane Stadium. 14-6 Highlander lead. It's going to be another handoff to TJ McMillan III. Once again, no particular hurry from Coach Andrew Pancotti's offense, who, by the way, keeps all three timeouts. And that's going to take us to halftime. So there you have it, halftime, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to step away, but stay here with us. We're going to have a broadcast of Highlander Highlights from this week. You're watching McLane Highlander Football. Where else? Right here on Highlander Highlights. Stay with us.
Enjoy the show. Let's go. Camera action.
Hey, you ready? Hands in the air, we just apply. Thank God that I'm alive. I've been popping all my life. It's like my birthday every night. I've been popping all my life. Thank God that I'm alive.
Enjoy the show. Enjoy the show. Enjoy the show. Enjoy the show. Enjoy the show.
show. Lights, camera, action.
Hey, you ready?
Camera action.
Hey, you ready?
He's in the air with just a fly. Thank God that I'm alive.
Camera action.
Hey, you ready? Hands in the air, we testify. Thank God that I'm alive. I've been popping all my life. It's like my birthday every night. I've been popping all my life. Thank God that I'm alive. I've been popping all my life.
Enjoy the show. Camera action.
Hey, you ready?
Enjoy the show. camera action.
Hey, you ready?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We hope you had a pleasant halftime. We're ready to begin the second half here in the Battle of Cedar. It's your Highlanders currently in the lead, 14-6. It's going to be Simon who's going to be able to feel this one. He's got open room around the left. However, it's closing up pretty quickly. There goes Demetrius Simon down the sideline. Good return by Demetrius Simon, the sophomore. Return from Simon, 43-yard line. That's where the Highlander offense will begin their first offensive series of the second half. Zamora is in the shotgun, flanked by T.J. McMillan III, a man in motion, which is Newhouse. It's a delayed handoff to T.J. McMillan III, and there he goes. And there he went. There he went. And there you go, T.J. McMillan III, putting the excitement into the night. And the Highlanders add to the lead. What a beautiful run by TJ. We've got a whistle while the kick is up in the air. Penalty marker. Let's await the call from the head referee. It's going to be encroachment on the Rough Riders. So Valadez this time gets a little more room to work with. He's going to put up the extra point. Right now, it is up and good.
Point after is up and good. 11:35 left in the third. It's your McLane Highlanders, 21.
What a beautiful touchdown run by McMillan III, adding to the Highlander lead. We will be right back. You're watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. We're back at McLane Stadium, where Ariel Valadez manages to get himself another touchback. So Valadez, 3 for 3 on extra points on the night where his teammates and he himself from the Valley Championship and state runner-up McLane Highlander soccer team are honored on the night. Highlanders and their head coach, Eric Rodriguez, treated us to a historic season last year, along with the Lady Highlanders, led by head coach David Alvarez, who treated us to another historic season. We'll call that one the double, as the Rough Riders hand off. That was Demarie Banks. So Banks with the short pickup for the Rough Riders. Great to have both soccer teams honored on the night. We're looking to improve that historic season this year as the pass is complete. That is a sea of Highlanders right there, getting to number 20, Sergio Jacuinde.
Highlander nation makes the noise.
So the money down for the Highlanders presents itself once again. Closter operating in the shotgun, dropping back, dropping way back, looking for Hakwinde again. Falls incomplete. Looks like there were maybe two chances to intercept that one. Noah Zamora unable to convert that second chance. And Mr. Excitement, Desir Newhouse, once again travel to the 50, just a little beyond it, awaiting the punt from Julian Maldonado. Here we go, Maldonado. Just able to get it off. And there's Newhouse from about the 45. He's going to make a man miss. And now he's going to reverse the field. There he goes. Desir Newhouse taking it all the way past the 30. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, when Desir Newhouse plays, you better have your cameras ready. You don't want to miss it. So the ball is placed on the 25, just 5 yards out of the red zone. Let's see what head coach Andrew Pancotti and the Highlander offense having the bag tonight. Zamora in the shotgun. McMillan the third, the feature back. It's gonna be a keeper by Zamora. A host of Rough Riders, or should we call them a cavalry of Rough Riders, on the stop. Of course, Roosevelt High School, around in Fresno since the year 1926, named after President Theodore Roosevelt, who of course was in command of the Rough Riders during the Spanish-American War, hence the name for Roosevelt. And meanwhile, your Highlanders have been in existence since around 1959, as we see Simon in motion. Of course, they take their name from the legendary Scotsman from Scotland. Zamora's gonna air it out. There's a flag on the play, looking for Simon. So pass is incomplete, and the call from the referee is gonna be that it's against the Highlander offense. We'll await the exact call right now. Eligible receiver, thank you so much to my friends up here in the booth for the valuable help. So that will move the Highlanders slightly back, as now we have the current callback going on between both sidelines. I'm looking in the direction of the Highlander hype zone, which is the student section, and it's good to see them out in full force. And meanwhile, also a tip of the cap to the Roosevelt Rough Riders, as we are currently looking at their section, and they've also brought the crowd on tonight. Both teams brought out their bands. It's a great atmosphere, this Battle of Cedar, ladies and gentlemen. I'm telling you, it is a good one. However, nothing is written for sure, still in the third quarter. Zamora in the shotgun. McMillan the third to his left. The snap, dropping back. Looking for a pass that is tipped and falls incomplete. So the Highlanders now working with the third down here. Once again, just to recap, since the year 2004, we were to put both of these teams on a balance. The balance would tell you that 13 wins for the Roosevelt Rough Riders since the year 2004, and 6 wins for your Highlanders since the same year, including once more the one-game win streak that the Highlanders are riding on. Great game, the Battle of Cedar, 65 years in the running. Hopefully many, many more years to come. It's It's a third down and 8 from the 29. Zamora, once again from the shotgun. Dropping back. Dropping back again. He's going to take it. He's going to pick up the first on his own. That's what it looks like. And there he goes. Or close to it, at least it looks like. The referee is pointing in the direction of the Rough Riders. We'll see if the chains move here. As of now, the chains have not moved. So the referees are currently talking with them as they stand by the fallen penalty marker. We await the call from the head referee, who now makes his way toward the box. The call is going to be personal foul levied against the Rough Riders. Automatic first for the Highlanders. Personal foul against the Rough Rider defense. Automatic. Highlanders. First down. So a first and goal, what appears to be from the 9. It's going to be a handoff, and now the play is whistled dead. Offsides on the Rough Riders. So the ball is going to move to the 4-yard line. 8:19 and counting down in the third. Highlanders 4 yards out from potentially another touchdown. We'll see what they decide to do. Now Jaden Turner is back in at quarterback for the Highlanders. The sophomore, Jaden Turner, with a man in motion, handing it off to McMillan the third, bouncing off one but can't bounce off the second and the third and the fourth. McMillan was able to evade the first wing, but couldn't deal with the rest of them. It's going to bring up second and goal. Loss of 4 on that one. Second and goal highlight. We attempted to check in on some scores from the North Yosemite League. We know that Hoover is playing Sunnyside tonight and Sanger West is playing Torres. We are unable to go ahead and get some scores for you at the moment, but when we do have them, we'll be happy to share them with you. As Turner looks like he's going to air it out, but he's going to keep it himself. And there he goes. Joe, just about short. Did he make it in? Did he make it in? Let's await the call. Let's await the signal. What's it going to be? Looking awfully close. It looked like maybe in the second push he would have made it. There is a penalty marker.
Turner on the run. Penalty marker. It's going to be a holding leg against your Highlander offense. That will move them slightly back.
And just like when it looked that Turner could have been close to the TD, a Highlander hold will move them a little back. So holding called on the Highlanders. The ball will now rest once again on the 8. Well, actually, correction, they're going to move it a little more back than that. It's now going to be on the 13. We've got Turner evading the pressure, airing it out. Looking for a receiver, which is Simon, and incomplete. Right in. Jaden Turner standing at 6'2", 170, the sophomore. Another dual threat. Good on the gridiron as he is on the hardwood. Just to go ahead and add him to the names, along with Desir Newhouse, Demetrius Simon, Jazz Boyland, Cedric Hughes, just to name a few. So we've got a third down for the Highlanders. New running back in, which appears to be Davian Yotu. Airing it out, and the pass is incomplete. So Demetrius Simon, once again unable to corral the ball, that brings up a fourth. The ball is on the 18, we'll see what the Highlanders decide to do. Now, I'm not a math major, ladies and gentlemen, but 18 plus 17 will make it a 35-yard field goal for Valadez, the senior kicker. The kick is up, it's traveling. And it is good. And I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, it's a treat to watch Ariel Valadez kick that football. We're going to step away for a few seconds. You are watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. We're back at McLane Stadium where you just witnessed another kickoff travel into the end zone for a touchback. Ariel Valadez shining on the night where both soccer teams were honored for the Highlanders, celebrating the double tonight. As we attempt to get a number on that running back, appears to be number 22 for the Rough Riders, Demarie Banks. Coaster dropping back, feeling the pressure. He's going to evade it. He's going to step out of the pocket and run. Then he takes a baseball slide, but not after picking up the first. Quarterback run by. So the Rough Riders picking up a first. 5:25 and counting down in the third quarter. Closer in the shotgun. Banks is his running back. Trips left for Closter as Banks takes the handoff. It's a sea of Highlanders. Second down, Roosevelt. Closter chased out of the pocket. The pocket's going to collapse, and so does Closter. Trying to get a number. So a third down for the Highlanders as they'll chase Coaster one more time. He's going to air it out, and that's almost picked. Demetrius Simon lamenting himself, wondering what could have been, and he's going to do the push-ups to go ahead and atone for that missed pick.
The pass is incomplete. Demetrius Simon on the coverage, and that brings up fourth down. Here, Newhouse. Back to return.
So as it usually is, Maldonado is back deep to punt for the Rough Riders. And Newhouse is back to return. Maldonado with another line drive that Newhouse is going to take out of bounds from about the 40. And there goes Dazier Newhouse. And able to gets stopped out of bounds. So the Highlander offense back on the field. 24-6, 3:53 left in the third quarter. It's been a good one so far for the Highlanders. However, once again, in the words of Yogi Berra, but later Lenny Kravitz turned into a song, it ain't over till it's over. As Jaden Turner hands off to TJ McMillan the third. Go. It's going to be a loss of about two as the ball currently sits on the 44. Second and 12. Once again, great to see the McLane Highlander crowd out tonight and the Rough Rider crowd also making their presence known. So Turner is in the shotgun. Along with McMillan the third, we've got whistles, and that is going to be a delayed game against the Highlanders. So just a few yards back for the Highlanders, who are now back into their own territory. Still, they did not move back past the 50. My bad, that was an optical illusion from myself. So they are over the 50, so into Roosevelt territory once more. There we go, and now this one's gonna get whistled dead. And now it's going to be a false start against the Highlanders. Will this move them back from the 50? It will, all right. Well, there we go. And a long ways to go for the first down. We'll call it second and 26. So Turner staying in at quarterback. McMillan the third is the feature back. There goes Turner, he's feeling the pressure. And the pass is intercepted. And there it is. He was feeling the pressure from, it looked to be Maldonado. So the Rough Riders get what appears to be their second turnover of the night, or maybe their third. I'd have to go back and check my notes. But the Rough Riders are back in business, at least their offense is. There's a handoff to the running back. He's going to run to a sea of red, and they still can't bring him down. Took a fleet of Highlanders to bring him down. So this injects a little bit of life into the Roosevelt crowd that is literally right below us here in the McLane Stadium press box. It's going to be closer. Going back, but he's feeling the heat. He is feeling the heat, and he tries to shovel it, but out of bounds. Highlanders on the chase. He runs out of bounds, and Highlander Nation, you know what to do. It's third down. So a third down for the Highlander defense and the Rough Rider offense. We will see how both teams respond. Closter in the shotgun with Banks to his left. Closter back to pass, feeling the heat. The pass is incomplete, intended for Young. Brings up a fourth. What do the Rough Riders do is the question. Do they decide to go for it on fourth? All signs would point to yes. And the offense is staying out there. There's Closter. And Banks is running back. So there he goes. Closter. Pressure again. And the pass is incomplete. Intended for Young. And that's how you do it. That's how you get the ball back. Highlanders take over on downs. Thunderstruck on the bagpipes to rile up the crowd. We see a cell phone flashlight, one lonely cell phone flashlight in the stands. So the Highlanders take over on downs. We've got JT Turner in at quarterback. It's going to be a handoff to McMillan the third. Between both sides. A great game to be a part of tonight. The Battle of Cedar between Roosevelt Rough Riders and your McLane Highlanders. 65 years and still going strong. That's going to take us potentially to the end of the quarter. Clock is counting down, and that's what it's going to be. We are at the end of the quarter. It's your Highlanders up 24-6 over the Rough Riders. You're watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights.
Leadership students, meet me on that end of the stadium, please. Leadership students.
after the quarter break. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Quarter number four, the last chapter, as Jaden Turner airs it out to Juju Scott. Juju Scott is stopped by Jeremiah Romero. We've got a current score to report from the Sunnyside and Hoover game. We're currently getting word that that score is Sunnyside 40, Hoover 6. No score update yet on Sanger West and Torres, but when we do have that, we will provide it to you. We will also provide it to the crowd here in the stadium. Rough Riders sending Jeremy Young back deep. Back deep for the Rough Riders, Jeremy Young. And Jaden Turner this time has a nice punt. And Young is unable to return. And the punt from Jaden Turner. There you go, the stadium crowd finding out about the score update. Here comes the Rough Rider offense in the fourth quarter. We'll see how Jackson Coaster and the Rough Rider offense respond. The handoff is to Banks, who's going to run into a sea of Highlanders and some Rough Riders thrown in there. Second down for the Rough Rider offense as the ball rests on the 49. You hear a little bit of singing coming from the Highlander sideline, the Highlander student section. They obviously have a lot to celebrate right now as Closter steps back, feeling the pressure again. Feeling the pressure again, they're unable to get to him. Jonathan Vargas is on the chase. Oh man. Intended for Fields. And a penalty marker on the play. And Fields will probably say that he was interfered with. We'll have to go ahead and see what the call is. There's two flags, actually. We see it's going to be pass interference for one against the Highlander defense. And an illegal man downfield for the Rough Riders. They're offsetting penalties. Replay of the down. So there we go. The play will go from the 49. 49 for the Rough Riders, and the handoff is to Fields once again, and there he goes, he's on the move. On the move, and it's gonna be two Highlander tacklers right there. It's gonna be Mendibles, and what appears to be, couldn't make out the other tackler. Highlanders. That brings up third down. So third down for the Highlander defense to work with. Third and short. Third and two to be more exact. As Kloster operates out of the shotgun, dropping back to pass. Boy, he's been feeling the pressure all night. And as he looks for Fields, the pass is incomplete. And another penalty marker on the play. Kloster looking for Fields. Penalty marker. And it's going to more than likely be another interference call. It's going to be pass interference on the Highlander defense. Moves the chains for the Rough Riders.
Call is pass interference on the Rough Rider defense. Automatic first for the Rough Riders.
So with 8:17 left in the contest, the Rough Riders catch a break with that one. And as we currently await the ball to make it to where the action is. There it is right there. It's going to be placed right about the 30. So new set of downs for the Rough Riders with Kloster in the shotgun. Kloster dropping back to pass. Raigosa on the chase. There goes Kloster, and he just runs out of bounds. So Raigosa Jr., the freshman, 5'11", 190, giving chase to Kloster. Kloster heard the footsteps, and he wisely ran out of bounds. There we go, second down. Dropping back, Raigosa giving chase again, along with Jonathan Vargas. And Kloster once again will run out of bounds. So the call, ladies and gentlemen, was either unsporting conduct or illegal participation, a sideline warning. But we're going to call a timeout here. The timeout was called by the Highlanders. We're going to step away here real quick. You're watching McLane Highlander Football and Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of the Art Venture Academy. Welcome back to McLane Stadium, where it's first and 10 for the Rough Riders, the ball on the 13. The Rough Riders are driving down the field, Kloster putting it up. The pass intended for Fields, incomplete.
Kloster's pass intended for Fields,
incomplete. Second down. You could hear one of the, there is a call against the Highlanders. It's going to be pass interference. Pass interference is levied against the Highlander defense.
The ball closer to the end zone for the Rough Riders.
So the Rough Riders catch a break with that one. And there we go. New set of downs for them. As they have chance to add to their score. So Closter now in what appears to be a pistol formation, as his running back Banks is directly behind him. There goes Closter. No handoff. Gonna get chased again. Collapsing pocket, and it's collapsing quickly. It's collapsing quickly. T.J. McMillan III. Boy, oh boy, what has he not done tonight?
Quarterback sack. T.J. McMillan III on the play. Injury timeout on the field.
And boy, oh boy, we have an injury timeout on the field for the Highlanders. Unable to make out the number of who the injured Highlander is, but Coach Andrew Pancotti has stepped out along with the McLane training staff, who's tending to the downed Highlander. We're gonna step away for just a few seconds. 7:02 left in the match. You're watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights, the production of the students of McLane's Adventure Academy. part of this game here, the Battle of Cedar, between McLane and Roosevelt. It's a handoff, but the running back does not make it into the end zone. Demarie Banks. Simon, of course, has all the right to celebrate that interception that could potentially maybe put the game in the freezer for the Highlanders. We're going to have a personal foul against the Rough Riders. And then we have...
We'll be right back.
JT's airing it out. JT's airing it out. And the pass is incomplete. Intended for Desir Newhouse. So Turner airing it out. A little bit of risky business for the Highlander offense with 2:40 left in the game. However, the pass. Joshua Kloster has kept all three of his timeouts for the Rough Riders. Meanwhile, head coach Andrew Pancotti has just used one. And the clock is now under a minute here at Roosevelt Stadium, but there is no sense of urgency, it appears, from either of the teams. And it looks like the Highlanders are going to go to victory formation. It's Turner under center. He takes a knee, but it's going to be delay of game.